Brainstorm on ABC 27 is brought to you by Penn State Milton S. Hershey Medical Center.
Welcome back. We have time for some more of your questions. Dr. McInerney is here. Thanks for being here. I had a pituitary tumor removed in 2010, but it has come back. Is this a normal occurrence? If it's not impacting my optic nerve, what type of treatment would you suggest?
Well, fortunately, pituitary tumors are usually benign, but they can recur. If they're not causing any symptoms, hormonal symptoms, or visual symptoms, they can be watched sometimes. But if they cause any trouble at all, you have to seriously consider treating that again. And that could mean either another operation to remove it or some type of radiation, either traditional radiation or radiosurgery with the gamma knife.
Okay, here's another question. I've heard in the news that using cell phones can cause brain tumors. Has any research been done to prove this right or wrong?
Well, that's a very common question we hear. In fact, there's been no study that's shown a clear link between cell phone use and tumors. And, you know, I always tell people, when you think about it, these are common devices that we use all the time. If there was going to be a relationship between those things, we would see it. We would have seen it a lot by now, and we haven't. So I feel very comfortable saying that there's no relationship between cell phone use and brain tumors.
And I was going to say, there are all different types of devices out there, and there's nothing over the past how many years?
Oh, at least 15 to 30 years that we've been using devices of a similar nature. And so, yeah, I think they're safe.
Okay, great. Thanks so much for joining us and answering our viewer questions. And we want to thank all the doctors here this evening for answering your calls. Once again, the phone lines are open until 8 o'clock this evening, or you can email your questions to questions@abc27.com. And we'll send it back to you in the studio, Chuck.
Thank you, Deborah. And we continue. Dr. Sheehan, now the advances in medicine, we have to ask, you've been practicing 10 years on this. Have you seen patients living longer because of what we're doing here?
Sure. Patients are certainly living longer. In just about every type of brain tumor, we've made advances in the last 10 to 20 years that have prolonged survival. Probably more importantly, though, is we've started to pay attention to something that's equally important as survival length. And that's quality of life. And Dr. Elena Ferrace, a neuropsychologist in our group, is a national expert in quality measures for brain tumor patients. You know, having an injured arm or leg is one thing. You can find ways to work around that and have a fairly normal life, but a brain injury causes a whole set of new problems that are often difficult to deal with, and it's those sort of quality indicators that we're looking at more closely in brain tumor patients.
Yeah, quality over quantity when it comes to the years, and that's improving all the time.
Absolutely.
Now, when we talked about support, no one just gets sick by themselves. No one gets injured by themselves. So when you have a brain tumor, it affects, as we saw in these reports, the entire family. Let's talk about support. What's available for the patient and the family for support?
Well, brain tumor patients and their families really get a double hit. There's a recovery from the medical illness, and there's dealing with a brain injury that often goes along with treatment and recovery and having a brain tumor. The patient caregiver stress, the family members, is quite high in brain tumor patients. We've started to pay attention to it from the medical side, as I mentioned. The patients themselves have started to recognize this and form groups and bond together and offer advice on how to cope with these issues to other brain tumor patients.
Now, families, support groups are invaluable, I would assume, in a situation like this. Where can people that are affected, someone in their family, themselves, where can they find support groups for families?
Right. The National Brain Tumor Society has some online advice for families and caregivers. There's a regional Facebook group called the Mid-Atlantic Brain Tumor Support Community. Some of our patients have found some good advice and comfort on that website as well.
All right, and here's a chance to kind of toot your own horn here a little bit. Let's talk about patient benefit of being treated and being dealt with there at Penn State Hershey Neuroscience Institute. Talk about that. What are all the pluses?
Well, in the last 10 years, we've put together a well-rounded, comprehensive, multidisciplinary team at the Neuroscience Institute. In some instances, that's been the addition of personnel like Dr. Michael Glantz, our medical neuro-oncologist, who is an international expert in the management of brain tumor patients. In some cases, it's been technological advances like the gamma knife and the Varian Trilogy system for radiation options and the infusion center for chemotherapy. In other cases, it's the clinical trial portfolio offering patients the latest and newest developments in brain tumor management. But really, with brain tumors and something this complex that crosses many disciplinary lines, the multidisciplinary approach is really key.
one of the first things we talked about in this show tonight was talking about the Gamma Knife system, and I hear there's a new one, or at least an advancement coming in that kind of procedure. Talk about that.
Right. In the spring, we'll be installing the new Gamma Knife system called the Perfection. This is really the first significant improvement in Gamma Knife technology in the last 35 years. This will allow us to treat more patients and do it in an easier manner. Certainly, there are some technical limitations with the current Gamma Knife system, and the Perfection was designed to finally eliminate many of those limitations.
That's an impressive unit we're looking there. Now, is that an artist rendition, or is that something that's being installed? How does that work? Yeah, that looks like something from outer space.
It does look like something from outer space. Those are just illustrations, but that's pretty close to what it looks like. There are multiple radiation sources, about 200 radiation sources, that are all focused to a single point. And in that point, the radiation dose is very high. But as soon as you get away from that point, the dose drops off dramatically. So again, a very high dose of the target and a very, very low dose everywhere else, which makes it lethal to the tumor and safe for the surrounding brain.
All right, looking at down the line into the future, could we see treatments that are less invasive for the patients?
Sure, we're making advances in that respect every day. Brain tumor surgery is not nearly what it used to be even 10 years ago. The recovery is often just a day or two at this point in the hospital, a few weeks of recovery at home in terms of energy and activity return. That certainly is one of the cutting areas for future developments, is minimizing and making less invasive the things we do to patients with tumors.
Now, somebody that just happened across this program this evening, they're concerned about that in their family, and they have reason to suspect maybe they need some help. What do you recommend they do?
Well, I'd recommend you start with your family doctor and explain to them the things that are concerning to you. Headaches are common in brain tumor patients, but headaches are very common in patients without brain tumors. So not everyone with a headache has a brain tumor. But your family doctor is probably the best person to start with to put the picture together and see where you should head, whether it's a stroke workup, a dementia workup, or something like a tumor workup.
Well, thank you, doctor. We covered a lot here in a very short time. Thank you for joining us tonight. We also want to thank the viewers for sharing your stories and sending in your questions. And if you'd like more information or would like to schedule an appointment with Penn State Hershey Neuroscience Institute, call 717-531-3828, or you can visit online at pennstatehershey.org/neuroscience. And when you call, mention you watched the show Brainstorm here on ABC 27. If you're on Facebook, become a fan of Penn State Hershey Med Center for news and upcoming special events. So keep that in mind. Thanks for watching tonight. And as we always do, we wish you Happy New Year this time, and good health throughout the year. Good night.